I would like to thank the organizers for the invitation. And my name is Gabriella, and I've been working on textile tools from Sicily. Today I'm going to show you one of the case studies for my PhD project that I just finished. I will present the case study of Montepolizzo in Western Sicily, where some very interesting groups of loom weights were found, which might be suggestive of the local tradition of setting up looms. The aims of this study was to contribute to the ongoing assessment of this site by looking at the loom weights, which were not studied in detail by previous studies. My functional analysis will be focused on a cluster of loom weights potentially fallen from a working loom at the time of the destruction of the site, and I will compare these loom weights with others found the same site. Specifically, the aim of this study was to understand whether local tradition of setting up a loom was practiced, whether a particular combination of heavy and light loom weights might have worked in the same loom setup, and I investigated the possible fabrics produced by using those loom weights. Unfortunately, I must admit that this paper won't answer these questions, but I will suggest a range of possibilities. So let me present the site. Montepolizzo was a settlement in Western Sicily, inhabited by a local community. It was located in an area densely occupied, not only by local communities, but also by Greeks and Punics. The main settlement is dated from the second half of the 7th century BC and was abandoned around the mid-6th century BC, possibly as a result of conflicts. As a whole, the material culture of Montepolizzo shows distinctive features. It was particularly conservative and appears reluctant to adopt foreign traditions. Similarly, its weaving tradition shows distinctive features, and loom weights differ substantially in shape, size, and manufacture from those of other nearby sites. On the basis of its location and material culture, the site has been traditionally connected with the ethnic group of the Elimians, although this is not widely accepted. Excavations carried out between 1999 and 2006 uncovered a settlement built at the highest point of the hill and along the slopes. Three main areas were excavated: the area A, B, the Acropolis, and Portella Sant'Anna, which is the focus of this paper. Portella Sant'Anna is located to the north of the Acropolis. Preliminary excavation in 2005 brought to light several multi-room buildings which might have been part of a workshop district. In one of these buildings, a group of 16 loom weights was found. From the scattered pattern, the excavator suggested that the loom weights might have been fallen from a working loom. Despite the lack of the exact find spot, the discovery looks interesting, as it can provide insights into the local weaving tradition. So here is the cluster of the 16 loom weights found. As you can see, there are 10 loom weights, of which two are fragmentary. These are truncated pyramidal in shape, weighing between 260 and 280. One bears an inside sign on the top, over there, which might be interpreted as a decorative motif, sometimes found on local pottery. Additionally, there are three heavier truncated pyramidal loom weights with no tapered sides, the one that I usually refer to as rectangular, and they weigh more than 800 grams. There are two more loom weights, different in weight and size. They are truncated pyramids, but much thinner than the others we just saw. One of these bears an inside hourglass decoration common in the local pottery. Finally, there is a rectangular prism object, which might be a loomway, with two holes through the long side. Although it's not quite clear that these loom weights constituted a complete set, which anyway, in my opinion, is unlikely, it's interesting that these loom weights are not randomly different. More interesting, a similar combination of heavy and light loom weights was found somewhere else at the site, which I'm going to show you in a while. My analysis tried to answer the question whether the heavy and the light loom weights would work all together and why there were different groups of loom weights. So I applied the calculation for potential loom setups as developed by CTR. The calculation with the light loom weights showed that they would work better with a warp thread tension of approximately 10-20 grams. Also, they might have been suitable for working with the 30 gram tension, although this 4 warp thread per centimeter is a limit value in the CTR guidelines, thus it cannot be taken as a sharp division. Then I applied the calculation for with the other loom weights, the one weighing more than 800 grams, and this demonstrates that they would work with a tension of 30 grams or even more. The calculation suggests that they might have worked all together with a common thread of 30 gram tension. So in this case, skilled weavers might have worked out the warp in order to get a balanced distribution of threads. However, there might be a specific reason for the presence of different distinguishable groups of loom weights. For instance, weavers might have used different level of tension in order to create textiles with different appearances. Or the difference in tension might point to the use of different twist or different yarn diameters in warp. The latter case would imply the use of different raw material. Also, it is possible that a certain combination of heavier and lighter loom weights could create particular decorative effects on the fabric through the natural color of plants and animal fibers. Although all of these are just speculations, it is interesting that another group of loom weights show a similar combination of heavy and light loom weights. This was found in House 1, Area A. In Room 1, a cluster of 25 loom weights was found stored in a bag, and they might thus have belonged to a different set for different loom setups. However, if we have a closer look, we can see that again they are not randomly different, but it is possible to distinguish different groups of loom weights on the basis of decorations, weight classes, and sites. Thus, there is a group of six loom weights, similar shape, weight, and sites, and with identical stamp on the top. Additionally, there are three more loom weights, heavier and thicker, and the rectangular shape, with the not tapered sides, and with decoration on the top. Then the remaining loom weights belong to both ranges of weights and sides, which means we got a number of loom weights similar to the first group with no decoration, and a number of loom weights like the rectangular one with no decoration. And plus, we got a few loom weights, truncated pyramids, but much thinner, like the ones we just saw in Portella Sant'Anna. So again, I applied the calculation for possible loom setups for tabby weave, and again, it seems they can work together in a same loom setup with 10 gram tension. But one might wonder why, whether there is a specific reason for this combination of light and heavy loom weights and decorated and non-decorated loom weights. So this is just an ongoing research. We need for the information, we need information on the exact spots, find spots, and we especially we need to test all these hypotheses. But it's notable that there is a peculiar combination of light and heavy and decorated and non-decorated loom weights seems to be common at Monte Polizzo, which might imply the use of different yarn diameter or different raw material, and even a different techniques for tying loom weights to the loom. Thank you very much.